Lord, mightiest prophet of the Lord.
Amen. Beloved people, the Lord Jehovah has spoken with me. This past night, the Lord, he spoke with me in a very, very tremendous way, in a very shocking manner. And that is the conversation I want to share with you now. The Lord, the King of Heaven, the King of Creation, the King of Glory, the Mighty God of Israel, he spoke with me this past night in a very, very shocking way, and a very tremendous way, and I want to share that with the nations of the earth, the nations that he created, the nations that he is very busy now preparing for the glorious coming of the Messiah. And in this past conversation, a very shocking conversation, the voice of the Lord is deep in the space. The voice of the Lord Jehovah, Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah El Olam, Jehovah Ori, Jehovah Hamelech, the King, Jehovah Hashophet, the Righteous Judge, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Elyon, Mekadishken, Jehovah El Hoseinu, Eloheka, the God, the Shepherd of our souls, the Redeemer of all the nations, the one without whom there is no Savior, the one that you see in the book of Isaiah 43 verse 11, when he says, I am the Lord, and apart from me, there is no Savior. The God of Israel spoke with me this past night. Again, the tremendous and terrible God of Israel, the one that removed the nation of Israel from Egypt, he spoke with me in a tremendous way this night, a very shocking way, when he took me on this 14th of November, the year 2017. He lifted me up and took me deep into space. And while there deep into space, the Lord, he commanded me to command. He gave me a command that I should command two stars and push them with my left prophetic hand, that they may collide in a most historic manner, never seen before. And I remember when I was commanded by the glory of the Lord that was next to me to push the two stars, and I do not know whether they are neutron stars or they are regular stars, but they look more like two neutron stars. And as I pushed my left prophetic hand, the dreadful hand of the Lord stretched it to go and push the two to collide. As I just began to stretch my hand towards them, they were pushed, and one of them was pushed a little faster than the other, and headed to the other one to collide with it. And it was such a spectacular, tremendous moment to see the two stars chase each other. And what is most astounding of it all is that as I stretched my left prophetic hand to push them, and they got unplugged, plucked off their orbits, and one began to pursue the other. It moved with such a tremendous force I have not seen before, and speed, the speed of light. And as that star moved at such a dreadful speed of light and force, headed towards colliding with the other, it was amazing that they went to two stages. I see two stages. I saw two stages way up there where the Lord had lifted me up to execute his agenda and his mission for creation, for this hour, for this dispensation, for the coming of the glorious King, the Messiah, for preparing the way for the coming of the Lord, for the return of the Lord Christ. As I pushed this star and it left with such unbelievable speed, the speed of light and force and power, I see two stages. They go into one stage when the most important thing that comes out is they form an eclipse before they collide. An eclipse. They form an eclipse, and it's such an eclipse in such a way that it's not a perfect eclipse. The other star is a little bit still raised above, elevated a little more, and this other star is three-quarter way, and you see more light still coming from the other star, and this one now masking the light from the other star. So they form an eclipse in two stages. And the first stage, I see this other star coming close to the other, and the other is a little bit more elevated, and this other one almost three-quarter way, masking, covering the light from the other star. And the light from the other star still comes through very brilliantly so, but again in the process of pursuing each other very violently, the most violent event in the universe, in the cosmos, in the creation of God on this earth and in the universe ever. Then they come to a second stage where now the eclipse is almost fully formed, but still peeping the other side, the margins of the other star still peeping, and then a tremendous historic collision takes place above the earth here. So right now on this 14th day of the 11th month, November, the year 2017, at about 5:20 p.m. East African time, I am prophesying a tremendous collision above the earth here, a collision of two heavenly bodies that will astound, will shock, will terrify, perplex, and cause the nations of the earth and all the other planets to shake. The Lord has now decreed that there is going to be a tremendous historic shaking of all the nations of the earth as he shakes the entire universe again. And this particular collision of the heavenly bodies above the earth that I am prophesying on this 14th day of the 11th month, November, the year 2017. This particular collision of the planetary bodies up here, of the two stars up here, of the heavenly bodies up here that I am prophesying at about 5:20 p.m. East African time, 14th of November 2017. This particular one is shocking because it's coming right on the face of the most recent collision of the two neutron stars that shook the entire universe and caused the entire cosmos, the entire creation of God, the entire heavenly bodies, the entire universe to shake and wobble dangerously as if they could crash. This particular one comes in the enlightenment of the most recent collision, when now the nations are aware of the gravity and the terror of the collision of the heavenly bodies up above here, and the severe consequence they bear on all creation, hyper mega, large, super huge, and small, the earth included. And this particular collision, I am prophesying on this 14th day of November 2007, above the earth here, this particular collision will be watched. I see people in an area, I see a marketplace, and then I see people who are scientists, astronomists, astrophysicists. I see them looking into their telescopes, and they see, they catch these two neutron stars, these two stars, these two heavenly bodies, before they crash, before they collide in a titanic collision, in a monumental collision, they are going to be able to catch them. The scientists will be able to discover them before they collide and catch them. I see the scientists looking through their telescopes and seeing them from those astronomical and reachable distances. And the Lord brought me from space when I pushed the two stars to collide as they moved at the speed of light. The Lord brought me back to the earth at a speed greater than the speed of light by trillions upon trillions upon trillions of times. And I came back in time and caught up with the astronomists, the scientists, and then I was able to put my eye also into their telescopes, and I saw the two stars before they collided. So I looked into the telescopes of the scientists twice, not once, twice, and saw the two stages of the eclipse. After that, the Lord took me back again at a speed greater than the speed of light by trillions upon trillions upon trillions and trillions of times greater than the speed of light,
and lightning. And then I caught up now with the last eclipse on the other side, deep into space, and I witnessed the execution of the command of God and the tremendous collision above the sky here, deep in space. And the unbelievable quake, the space quake, the shaking of all the planets ever created by Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah El Olam, Jehovah Mekadish Ken, Jehovah Eloheinu, the tremendous, terrible God of Israel, a tremendous, historic, universal quake shook all the planets, including the bigger suns, 600 billion times bigger than our sun. They wobbled and almost crashed on each other. Hey! What a terrifying moment in the history of the universe. That he could send a dreadful servant, the most dreadful prophet, to execute the most dreadful universal earthquake, universal quake, that will shake the heavenly powers, the heavenly bodies, until they almost crash on each other and lead to one of the biggest, almost lead to the biggest implosion ever. Hey! What manner of days are these? What manner of servant is this? That the Lord could unleash him with such tremendous power, unspeakable power, to execute and institute forth and implement a universal earthquake that shakes even the biggest planets, that make our sun look like a little dot on a piece of paper. Hey. If you could see what I have seen, you'd surely know the time has changed in heaven at the throne of my God. The tremendous God of Israel, the terrible God of Israel, Jehovah Haver Shelly. Jehovah, my friend. Oh, how I wish you could see what I have seen. You would have prepared for the coming of the Messiah yesterday. You would have rejected all manner of sin, apostasy, defilement. You would have aligned your life with the command of God, the ordinances for this hour, the return to righteousness, the return to holiness, absolute holiness. And I have seen a historic collision take place deep in space above the earth. It will shake all the nations of the earth. The earth will shake like a piece of paper. Hey! What manner of days are these? The biggest suns that are bigger than our sun in this solar system, the biggest stars that are 600 billion times bigger than our sun, they will wobble like a piece of paper. The power and the authority, the enormous power that the Lord has bestowed on my left prophetic hand, I have seen it execute the agenda of Jehovah deep in space. And it's unbelievable. It is terrifying. The Messiah is coming. The Lord Christ is coming back. The King of Glory is coming. Because the explosion that comes out of that collision was unbearable. It shook the universe in a manner never ever before. The Lord is determined this time around. And this particular one, the Lord asked me to decree that this one will now happen soon, strictly based on the words of my tongue. This one will now happen soon, strictly based on the words of my tongue. Soon. You will not wait any longer, because time is over and the voice of the Lord is now deep in space. He is speaking from the depth of space now. There is a tremendous collision coming to take place up above the earth here, deep in space. I have seen it. The Lord has sent me and given me power to execute it. And I've used my left prophetic hand. It's unbearable. It is unbearable. It is terrible. I am prophesying a historic collision that is about to take place up above the skies here, in the heavens above, and it will shake the heavenly bodies like never seen before. The Bible says in the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 25 on, he says, and there, I'm reading Amplified, and there will be signs in the sun and moon and stars, and upon the earth there will be distress, trouble, and anguish of nations in bewilderment and perplexity, without resources, left wanting, embarrassed, in doubt, not knowing which way to turn. At the roaring, the echo of the tossing of the seas. And he says, verse 26, men swooning away, or expiring with fear and dread and apprehension and expectation of the things that are coming on the world. For the very powers of the heavens will be shaken and caused to totter, meaning to tear, to crack. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great, transcendent, and overwhelming power, and all his kingly glory, majesty, and splendor. Beloved people, I have seen the coming of the Messiah. And the Bible says that when you see the shaking of these heavenly bodies here, however large, however small, the tottering of the same, the quivering of the universe, the wobbling of all the galaxies and the planets, then should you raise up your heads and your hands, for behold, your Redeemer cometh, the Messiah cometh. I have seen the Lord Jehovah send he that speaks with you deep into space, the depth of space. Listen to me, the angels in heaven. Listen to me, the nations of the earth. Listen to me, the angels and the heavenly hosts in the kingdom of God Jehovah in heaven. The Lord Jehovah has commanded me to push the stars to collide. And I've seen a historic collision above the earth, deep in space. Listen to the words of my mouth, ye nations of the earth. Listen to the pronouncements of my tongue, ye heavenly hosts of the kingdom of my God. The Lord Jehovah has instructed me with my left prophetic hand to command a historic collision of the heavenly bodies above the earth. And I've seen a historic collision. I have seen a historic quake, the quivering and the shaking of the entire creation created by God in the book of Genesis. And it created unbearable terror, perplexity, the quivering and the shaking of the universe. I have seen the shaking of the heavenly bodies. I have seen even the fabric of space almost tearing. It was unbelievable. People ran up and down. I have seen an eclipse on their path to the collision. And so on this day, speaking from the depth of the space, deep space, I have commanded the collision of stars above the earth to prepare the way for the glorious coming of the Messiah. That all the heavenly bodies may also be shaken from slumber. That they too may know that the Messiah, the King of Glory, is coming with great power to take the bride, to take the glorious church, to take the holy church. I have seen the Lord shake the entire universe to prepare the way for the coming of the Messiah. In these words, I have decreed with my terrible prophetic tongue and executed them into command by my left prophetic hand, so they shall be. And when they come to pass, then you shall know that only Jehovah, the God of Israel, He is God. Only the Lord Jehovah is God and is to be worshipped. And that all the other idol gods must now be crushed. And that I am His servant, the promised messenger in the Bible. The one the scriptures in the Bible promised that would come with tremendous historic power to shake the universe, to bring down the powers that be, and prepare for the unshakable kingdom of God. I have seen a tremendous collision up in the skies above. And this time around, I have seen scientists observing them. I have looked into the telescope myself. I looked with them. I saw before the collision, they were able to catch it, to discover them. And then during the collision, this is he about whom the Bible spoke when the Lord promised that he would send you the messenger. He would send you Elijah, the great prophet, the dreadful prophet, the terrible prophet of Jehovah, the terrible prophet of Israel. And he would do these terrible things to cause the nations to wake up from slumber and know that time is over and the Messiah is coming and return to holiness and righteousness and reject sexual sin, that all the false prophets may now be slayed. That all the false apostles may now be brought to slaughter. That the church of Christ may now return to righteousness, may prepare the glorious garment of the Lord for the wedding of the Lamb of God. Right now, the nations are sitting on the verge of eternity. And these are the landmarks for the dreadful day of the coming of the Messiah. This is he about whom the prophet Malachi spoke and said he would come and return the hearts of the nations back to the Father. This is he about whom the Messiah spoke when he said there would be the shaking of the heavenly bodies before his return. This is who about whom the prophet Joel spoke when he said he would appear into the sins and shake the heavens above the earth before the Messiah comes. Prepare the way. Shalom Haverim. Shalom, shalom, Toda Rabba. Toda Lahem. Toda Yom Tov.